Well, I'm going to speak up because it's kind of noisy. It's raining out, and this phone's pretty bad at recording audio if you're behind it anyway. But a little update on the bikes. I've been riding this one around trying to get it running, but I think it had bad gas in it and probably the carbs gummed up. You know, who knows? You know, it would run on like half choke, and then if you try to take the choke off, it would stall. And if you left the choke all the way on, it would sputter. So, you know, it's just the normal kind of stuff when someone doesn't take care of their bike. Took the gas tank off. I took the air cleaner off. I'm going to take the carb off and either clean it or put a brand new one on there. I haven't decided yet. Took that other, what was that other thing? There's that double muffler they had on there. I couldn't really get the other part off, but I don't know, maybe I'll just wrap the whole thing. What else? On the kill switch, that screw that goes into plastic is stripped out, so I gotta put some super glue or CA in there and re-drill it out. This was all, the throttle was all kind of rusted. Looks like it had been out in the rain a couple times at least. So I took that apart and lubed it up and got it working nice and pretty good. These are always a pain. I'm going to get another spring that goes from here to here and eliminate that one, because those, I cut it in half and stretched it out and it's a little better, but I'm probably just going to need a new gasket there, it looks like. Probably just going to eliminate that and put a spring from here to here, like I have on my CT200U. What else? Yeah, pretty much all the normal stuff, you know. There's no crankshaft bolt here. So I stole one off of that one just to get it running. You know, the rear axle was loose. Steering stem was loose. This was loose. These I haven't even checked, but the front axle is probably loose. The chain looks pretty good on this one. Looks like someone just replaced this one maybe and has taken pretty good care of that. I don't know if that, how much compression that engine has, or if it's fine. It seems to pull real easy. I don't know if that's good or bad. Probably just gonna put a new carb on or clean that one. Maybe go back to the stock filter and muffler, possibly, or I'm not sure. What else for this one? Yeah, I took the tank. I took the little fake tank off because it was falling. The lid was falling off. I'll have to probably, I don't know, maybe I'll just run them like that. I'm not sure what I'm going to do for this. But really, they're in pretty good condition, considering. It looks like somebody basically took these and just had someone put them together at the store, or they got them, you know, put together somehow. If they did it, and they just ran them. And they ran them for like a whole summer, and then, you know, they quit running right. They probably had, you know, this one had, at least this one had an air filter cover on it. This one had no air filter cover on it. So I think it was raining, water was getting in there. That one, the oil actually looked like oil. This one, I'm glad I didn't run it because I checked and the oil is like milky white. It has had water in there or something. So I'm going to have to drain the oil out of that one. I don't think the engine seized, but even if these didn't have engines at all, I would have bought them maybe for $100 less. For $150, I probably would have paid $100 just for a rolling chassis to get the shocks and stuff. But this is funny. I got this thing off of here. This crazy thing. They had bolts just, look at that. They had them just going all through it. Crazy. They had all these bolts in there. Screws, wood screws, sheet metal screws. I just took this off, put lock, it was all loose and rattling around, so I took got some lock washers and tightened it up. I cut this wrap off right here. I'm probably gonna cut this right here and put an RLV muffler on it and an air cleaner kit on this one. Or maybe I'll put a brand new engine on one of these. I'm not sure. I did ride these around, at least that one. And they are real comfortable to ride around. The handling is, I like the handling better on that one because it's more, you know, it feels more rigid. I think the shocks are just too squishy and they do some weird things, but I don't know. Maybe higher speed would be better or worse. I don't know. But they are a lot more comfortable, for sure. So, but maybe the CT200U would be more comfortable if I got a shock on there. So, I'll play around with that, see how it goes. This one, everything was loose. I just, these handlebars either got bent or I think they were on backwards. I'm not sure if there's an angle to them, but I just took them off and took everything off, switched the handlebar around. It feels better now. I adjusted the rear axle to tighten up the chain and even it out. That was tight at least. This thing is broken here. See if I can get it. Yeah, see, this is broken. I need a new brake lever. I mean, it works, but it's kind of dangerous because if that falls out when you're riding, you need the brakes. So it needs a new brake lever. I don't know much about this one yet. I still got to work on it. Oh, another thing I got to do is fix these kickstands. I got to either cut them or bend them out a little bit or something because these things, this one already fell over. Look at that. It's like basically standing straight up. And you breathe on it wrong. If it's like this, it'll fall right over. That's why I got this chair there. Glad I did, because it did fall over once. Hit the chair, didn't hit my bike, which is good. So yeah, I think they were a good deal. Rolling chassis, I can figure out what I want to do with them, but man, I'm glad I got them. Maybe I'll just get them running and keep them. I don't know. Maybe make one with a torque converter and soup it up and make one just kind of stock for like if a smaller kid wants to ride it, it's not too crazy. I don't know. Pretty cool though. Another little update. I guess this will be thing one. That was made in November 2017. And this one was made in March 2018. So that one's newer, but I think that one was better taken care of. There seems to be some rust. It seems like this one got left out in the rain once or twice more than that one, because there's like rust on the fork tubes and there isn't on that one. Another thing, got all this tape off of here. The seat, he's right, the seat was perfect before they put the tape on. First it ripped there, and then it took a bunch of stuff up here. So the only thing wrong with it was the bolts fell out. The threads look okay. So instead of just getting bolts that fit, they just taped the freaking thing on there. Like, and wreck this seat. We'll probably get another seat, or I have stuff I can cover that with, actually. It won't look as nice, but that's a shame. There's tape all over these bikes. It's just crazy how much tape is on them, but anyway, so these are both newer than mine. Mine was made in January 2017. So he said he got them new this year, and that's probably true. Or like he said, he's had them for about a year. So yeah, that's probably true. So I'll update when I get one of them running, I guess, if I find anything else interesting about them.